Hello dear students, welcome back to biology class. In this video, let us continue with the second chapter, that is sexual reproduction in flowering plants. This is 10th video from this chapter. In this video, let us discuss about the outbreeding devices, one of the very important concept. So before understanding what are outbreeding devices, let us recall that we know that majority of the flowering plants, they produces hermaphrodite flowers. What do you mean by hermaphrodite flowers? That is, they are bisexual flowers. In such cases, the pollen grains are likely to come in contact with the stigma of the same flower, that results in the self-pollination. But the continued self-pollination results in inbreeding depression. What is this inbreeding depression? See, inbreeding depression means the continued self-pollination, that is inbreeding depression. The continued self-pollination results in inbreeding depression. What is inbreeding depression? Inbreeding depression means the continued self-pollination for more than 5 to 6 generation, the offsprings will lose the fertility, and also the offsprings are with a low yield. So to avoid such conditions, the plants have developed many devices to discourage self-pollination, and the plants wanted to encourage the cross-pollination. Okay, so they developed several mechanisms. Those devices or mechanisms are known as outbreeding devices. How can you define outbreeding devices? These are the devices which are developed by the plants to avoid self-pollination and to encourage the cross-pollination. Now let us discuss about the various outbreeding devices which are developed by the plants. The first one is, that is protoandry and protogyny. That is, in some species, the pollen grains and stigma receptivity are not synchronized. It means either pollens are released before the stigma becomes receptive. That condition is known as protoandry. You look at this in this flower. Here, the pollen grains, the anther matures and dehiscence of the anther takes place, and all the pollen grains are released. After some time of the pollen release, the stigma becomes receptive. Look at this, the example clerodendron. In this plant, look at this, the stamens are matured and the pollen grains will be released. Okay, but the stigma is to mature. After the dehiscence of the anther, the stigma becomes receptive. This condition is known as protoandry. Whereas in some other flowers, the stigma becomes receptive much before the dehiscence of the anther. Look at this, in this flower, the stigma is receptive and anthers still become the mature. After the when the stigma loses its receptivity, the stamens matures, the anther matures, and there will be release of pollen grains. Okay, so the first outbreeding device is the pollen release and stigma receptivity are not synchronized. In such cases, either the pollen released before the stigma becomes receptive, or the stigma becomes receptive much before the release of pollen. The second outbreeding devices is the anther and stigma, they are placed at different position. You look at this image. In this flower, this is a long styled flower. Look at this, this is the stigma and this is style. The style is long, and the filament of the stamen, they are short, so that there is a lot of distance between the stigma and pollen grains. In this condition, look at this here, the chances of pollen grain coming in contact with the stigma is very less. There are some other flowers where the short style flower, here style of the pistil is, the carpel is very short, and the anthers are placed at higher position. In this condition also, the pollen grains coming in contact with the stigma are very less. The third outbreeding devices is self-incompatibility. What is self-incompatibility? Here, the stigma, it does not accept the pollen grains of the same flower. This is the genetic mechanism and it prevents the self-pollination. In this image, it's very clear. Here the stylish, there is S1 and S2 and this is S1 and S2. Here this stigma, it is able to recognize the pollen grains of S3 and S4 so that there will be a germination of the pollen grain takes place and pollen tube grows and fertilization of the ovule takes place. But in this case, this stigma, it is able to recognize the pollen grain of S3, but it does not accept the pollen grain of S1 because it is of same type. So here there will not be germination of pollen tube and pollen tube will not reach the ovary and there will not be fertilization of the egg. In this case, this is the stigma, it consists of S1 and S2 genes and here the pollen grains, they also contain S2 and S1 genes. In this condition, these both the pollen grains will not germinate and they will fail to reach the ovule and to bring the fertilization. Okay, so the self-incompatibility, this is one of the genetic mechanism and it prevents the self pollen from the fertilizing the ovule by inhibiting the pollen germination or pollen tube growth in the pistil. Then fourth one is the plants produces unisexual flowers, that is monoecious condition. On the same plant, the male and female flowers are produced. It prevents the autogamy but not gynogamy. For example, in case of castor and mace, these plants, they produce unisexual flowers, that is male and female flowers, they are produced on the same plant. The fifth outbreeding device is the production of the unisexual flowers on the different plants. For example, in case of papaya, the male and female flowers are produced on different plants. You look at this, this plant produces only female flowers and this plant produces only male flowers. This condition is known as dioecious. Okay, in this condition, both autogamy and gynogamy, this condition prevents both autogamy and gynogamy. Okay, so this is very important concept from this chapter. That is the recall for you important outbreeding devices. The first one is number one, in some species the pollen release and stigma receptivity are not synchronized. In such cases, either the pollen is released before the stigma becomes receptive, that is protoandry, or stigma becomes receptive much before the release of pollen grains. Number two, in some other species the anther and stigma are placed at different positions so that the pollen cannot come in contact with the stigma of the same flower. The third one is self-incompatibility. It is the genetic mechanism and prevents the self-pollination from the fertilizing the ovule, inhibiting the pollen germination or pollen tube growth in the pistil. Number four, the production of unisexual flowers. If both male and female flowers are present on the same plant, such as in case of castor and mace, it prevents autogamy but not gynogamy or gynogamy. Fifth one is dioecious, that is in several plants such as papaya, male and female flowers are produced on different plants. That is, each plant is either male or female. This condition prevents both autogamy and gynogamy. These are the five important outbreeding devices. Thank you.